Hello there, lads, lasses, and all other life forms. The Almighty Blob here, and welcome back to... Welcome to Kona! Now, this is a Kickstarter game. Survival adventure, I do believe. Very nice music. Very nicely done. And it looks good. It looks really good to be able to make its Kickstarter goals and achievements. It's going to be something impressive, or something of a weird niche angle. So let's get straight into this. I don't know what it's about. I've got a little bit of it. It's a bit of survival, a bit of adventure, a bit of story. Ooh, chapter one. Yes, and it's an episode sort of game. So I don't know how long this is. I don't know how big it is. I don't know how much we'll find out. I don't know whether you need to play the beta or the to understand it and stuff like that. I'm pretty much sure you don't, but you never know with these sort of games. So, come on, Kona. What have you got for me? What have you got for me? Ooh. Nice Jeep, I'm guessing. Northern Quebec. Canada? Quebec? Yeah.
Carl Faubert sought information for
1970.
That is to say that ever since he returned from Korea, after having served with the armed forces, he had been working as a private investigator in Montreal. William Hamilton, a rich industrialist, had gotten in touch with him regarding a simple vandalism issue. Nothing to write home about. Not worth hiring a private eye either, just so he can drive for hours on rough roads. But that's how it had always been. The client pays, Carl gets it.
Ooh, we can drive. Ooh. Can I stop? Can I do stuff? Turn off. I get you. What's this? Step out? Oh, I can get out. Ooh, I can twist my neck. Alright, let's get going. I'm guessing we don't need to stop here.
They had set up to meet at the general store. His client's business. Well, actually, the entire village had William Hamilton's name written all
over. So William Hamilton seems to be an important rich figure in this part. Whoa. Single lane traffic here. I'm going 30 miles an hour. Feels like I'm going way faster. Let's have a look.
When the roads were bad, muddy, or snowed in, it was customary around these parts to close them off. But it was also customary to ignore those signs entirely and drive there.
Oh. So it's like a proper adventure. Let's have a look around. Ooh, let's have a look. Okay, we've got jeans, shoes, and a normal Canadian jacket. Open. Empty bottle, one. Why do I need that? I'm guessing there's not going to be... Whoa, okay. It's got some masks. Let's have a look around here. Let's see how good detail this is. Dun, dun, dun. Saving already. Okay. Open. Bolt cutters. Fire starter. Oh, I don't want to make fires. Sensitivity is a bit high. That can be easily changed, I do believe. Can I run? Yes, I can run. Okay. Let's have a look in the shed. Telephone? Can I see if there's any dial tone? No. Is there something? No. I thought there was something written on the plank then. Read. Flyer. Manastan. It will be good. Oh. Northern Quebec and its inexhaustible resources. The province of Quebec sits on inexhaustible abundance of natural resources. Why not take advantage of this? Our valuable minions could travel the world and reach places as far as Dallas, USA. Get involved, invest now, Quebec's economic might will be awakened. The heart of the wilderness, the north is swarming with wolves. No! No! Get back! Read! Oh, you... Doesn't matter then. Alright, alright. So we're in part of Quebec that's got a really, like, high natural resource. Maybe investors.
Hamilton never mentioned a road-blocking barrier. Why was it needed here in the back of beyond? That would, however, be a mystery for another day. Carl had waited long enough for someone to come and raise it.
Okay. Is this going to be like the Stanley Parable thing?
Still not a soul in sight. There was no point in waiting any longer. Carl had to figure this one out by himself. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store. It was time for him to get down to...
Is it going
to
be like the Stanley Parable where you can choose to ignore the narration? I guess not. I bet not. Anyway, let's get going.
William Hamilton enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forests. Not too far from here.
Dun, 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 dun. Whoa.
The local populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others an aging Englishman.
Ah, the English. Always ruining the everything.
Hated him enough to go on.
There's the masks again. Are these masks important?
Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses. But the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people.
The Cree people. Oh, what's this? Is it just branches?
Given these circumstances, Carl reckoned that a good number of people
rubbish
were feeling compelled to oppose Hamilton in one way or another. So far, only the industrialist's house had been a target, but soon enough, Carl thought, the target would become the man himself.
Okay, that doesn't sound creepy at all. Come on, baby, get up this hill. Shift it down a gear. There we go. Holy fuck! Car out of nowhere. Mystery car. Ghost car. Canada car! Few hours later. I'm not gonna be tortured, am I? It's not one of them games. Okay, I've just woken up. Oh.
Carl needed to get out of there. The cold and the pain required urgent care.
I'm guessing that's stuck then. Okay, okay. Use the snow. Keep it cold. Coda. I haven't really seen much to create a first basis yet. The gameplay is good. Sort of sandboxy open world. Ah. Deposit, withdraw. Is there anything in here that I can do? I'll withdraw the fire starter. So I can put stuff in the back of there. Let's have a look.
The driver had taken off. It was still best to check it out and leave nothing to chance.
Okay.
Carl needed
unlocked. Can I crouch? Ah, yes. Oh. Read. I love that.
Such heart-wrenching Nordic poetry that...
Isabel, you gave meaning to everything.
Don't care much about flowery language.
Shut up, narrator. Isabel, you gave meaning to everything. When you disappeared, so did purity. I would defend purity against the winds, the tides, against ice and blizzard. Okay.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Alright, give me a chance.
This deep in the country, his last hope was to find an abandoned garage or a farm by the road.
What does the sign say?
His life depended on it.
Okay, do I go down or forwards? Okay, I'll go forwards. I'm guessing this was going to be the main road to the place where I wanted to go anyway. When under stress, Carl is less accurate and runs shorter distances. Okay, I can't go that way. Is there anything around here? Okay, just sticks and snow. So I'm going to go down here then. I can't avoid it. Okay, this is what that called. Got a hook. Let's get in a hook. Let's get warm.
The cold. cold was burning Carl. He would not hold up much longer. He had to warm himself.
Let me shut the door then. Oh, crap. Turn on. Why is that not turning on? We've got light. Matches.
Even better than he had hoped. Carl Faubert had succeeded once more and was now on his way to new adventures.
Oh, I've got... Am I gonna... Why can I not light a fire? Ah, there we go. One log. That's what I needed. Go on, stupid door. Hold it. There we go. Ah, so we've got a nice, neat system in here in the top corner. Why? There we go. See in the top corner? We got heat. Cool. So, we've got some heat now. That's good. That's good. What do I need to do? Okay, let's have a look. Documents. Isabel photo again. Number 2. Okay. Map. What map have we got? Is that me? Is that a little... Yeah, that must be me. General store. Unless I'm at the top. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. So what else have we got? Equipment. We've got a flashlight. Let's have a look. Yes. Okay. Let's close that. We don't want the fire to go out. I'll have another log. There we go. We've got another log. Let's have a look up here. Press circle to de-equip. Cool. It's all coming together. It's all coming together. Ah, there's nothing up here. There's the cars. The music was a bit jolty then. Seems to be a massive circle here. Okay, we're getting fires. It looks like this is going to be our little base of operations. Can I take a spade? There might be something else I've missed in here. Can we try and get the car out? Is that the point? Carl is in bad shape. He needs to heal his wounds and warm his body before going any further. Ah, heal my wounds! Alright, let's get inside. See if we can heal myself.
Carl, ever diligent in his work, always carried his log on, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations.
Son of a wealthy Chicago banker, Hamilton made his own gold. Yeah, that's his thing. Hamilton is accusing the Cree people of attacking his estate. The Cree certainly do not hold him dear. His mind's probably upset the green spirit. An accident. I haven't been this shaken up.
Scratches did not stop Carl. His mother would be so proud.
Yes. Iron locked box. Would it be wrong to look inside? Surely I would find some clue as to who that reckless driver was. I'd still need to find the key, though. Okay, so we need to go find the key. I never looked in the trunk. Ah, there you go. That's what I missed. Okay. Consumables. Health is up. Cool. Carrying stuck in snow, it will not move without help. Alright. Lay chains. There you go. Do I have to lay chains on all of them? Or just that one? There we go. There we go. We're getting somewhere. There we go. Simple chain. Okay, okay. Don't go too far. There we go. Let's get out of here. I feel like I'm going to run over someone. Someone's going to jump in front of me. Could be wrong. Was there something on the road then? I don't know. Don't run out of petrol. This van sounds like it's on its last legs. Manastan region.
Spread out on a few acres of untouched forest, bellowing caribou, everlasting snow, and undefiled lakes. The Manastan region was no tourist hub. It was said to have been populated for millennia by Cree people, and ever since the industrial era, by the metal mining industry.
Okay, okay, okay. We're getting a bit more history here. There's a letterbox there. I don't know if I should be going somewhere specific.
The truck was running on fumes. Good thing that the general store was
closed. Alright, alright, I'm going the right way. I think. Oh, it's loaded. Cutscene? Maybe not. Here we go. Oh no, don't die. Come on, come on. It's just there. That's it. That's it. We're here. Rendezvous. Turn it off. There we go. Hello. Right. Can we... Petrol. We need petrol. Or gas. Gas, since we're in America. Canada, should I say. No? You packed... Turn the engine off, why don't you? You idiot. Oh, you bloody ass. Need key. Whoa!
Carl had no trouble recognizing his...
Hello?
He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure
well,
that out.
Well, whoopity f-
But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close. That the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized.
Well, it looks like there was a scuffle. Place is a mess. Oh, well, obviously. Okay, okay. Take out camera. His hand's really weird. Okay. Let's have a good angle, man. Good angle. Let's get you all in. There we go. Yeah, let's keep the picture. Okay, okay. Envelope.
What could be inside that envelope?
Well...
Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service.
Okay. Is this coming like Project Zero now? Can I remove the camera? Okay. Let's get a light on. This place is a mess. It's just the same thing again. Coca-Cola. Yes, obviously.
Carl felt a chill down his spine and had a terrifying realization. If Hamilton was dead, then he was going to pay him.
Okay, this guy seems a bit... Like, let's not phone anyone up. Okay, we'll take all the fire starters. There's been a murder! What are you going to do? Just run around and just forget about everything else? Don't phone the local police. Punch the price, two numbers minimum, for sale. Turn the crank 2 times, punch the machine if it doesn't work. Okay. Secretary wouldn't be luxury. Oh, can I take a map? Read flyer. Quebec's economy is booming. The north of Chickamauga? Chickamauga? That's not it, but I like to call it Chickamauga. Area's population will soon reach 30,000 souls, among which thousands of happy families will be prospering, thanks to the hard labour of their fathers, who will be contributing valiantly in expanding Quebec's national wealth. The mines and sector. I think it's just. Did you know? No! Right, this is going to get annoying if it's going to be that sensitive. Did you know that since 1960, Canada tripled the amount of resource royalties it collects? Did you know that the country's true source of richness is lying under your very feet? It's mining then. What we got here? Okay, I think we'll leave the electricity on, please.
The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time.
Oh, okay. Whoa, wolves!
Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military training. Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears?
Okay. Oh.
Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem.
I just saw that, don't worry.
An explosion suddenly occurred outside.
No. Why did I leave the windscreen wipers on? We ain't got electricity here. Oh, fuck. Oh, what was it now? Push two numbers. And then sail. Wind it twice. Post key. That's what we needed. Change. Garage key. Customer credit.
According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though.
Okay. Tape. Matches. Nothing in that one. Just everything I seem to need. Okay, we got our letter from Giles.
Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store. That made him one of Hamilton's employees.
Yeah.
A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see.
The narration is going to get so annoying. Especially when you want to read something. It's going to get really annoying. You know what, Hamilton? I have a frog in my throat. And when people have a frog in their throat, they do not take risks by going to work. Customers couldn't catch it right. I'm a wise man. Not to worry, I will have a nice doctor's note, which I'm going out to get right now. Sadly, in the meantime, we'll have to close down the shop unless you would like to come in and fill in for me. I wouldn't dare advise you, after all. You must know how it's done since it's yours now. With kind regards, your dedicated manager, Giles. Okay. Oh, fuck. Has someone turned the power off? Okay, the power's still on. Can we fix this?
Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem.
The hell's this?
Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first.
Ah! Footprint. Oh, it's wolves.
Prints? Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was it a possible lead?
Ah, so that's what that's for. That's nice. I'm having logs though. I want logs. Oh, inventory full. Oh.
The Polaroid. Carl's long-standing and faithful ally.
Okay, yeah, I don't care. Let's get rid of some logs. No, I don't wanna. Okay, we got propane. Draft letter. Let it be known you are nothing more than a bygrander, a robber, a garbage hoarder, a viper. Seems like some villagers barely tolerated each other. Seriously, this narration. I'm trying to read. You're sucking out all the environment on this. The suspense. Okay. We'll start a fire here. Okay, we got another car. The cleanest spot in the area. Okay. What we got? Okay. There's nothing in here. We're gonna need power. And I think it said something. I can't open the door. Okay. I don't like it that the doors only open one way as well. That is rather annoying. Let's open up the post.
Something fell to the bottom of the box. The murder weapon. What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky. Everything made sense now. Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spy.
Narration, shut up! As a citizen of Majesty and the free economic chambers of the world, that I must address that what follows to the proper authorities. The worst is happening at this very moment. I cannot write at length, but I am requesting immediate help from my country. I believe the free world is in grave danger. A member of my community, the Honorable... Okay. No, I didn't want that. What's in here?
A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit.
At least the body's still there. So I need pliers. Ah, yes. Move that. I love that. Scissors. I need some of these. Can I have one of these? Fuck's sake. Seriously? No pliers in here. Ah, I forgot these drawers. I love that. Hardware. There we go. Funky music. Can I not open that? Nope. Alright, we've got pliers now. We can fix the generator. Okay. Let's get the pump going. We came here for petrol. Can I have a beer? Anything up here? Sherry. Okay, that's good. Don't, no one behind me, please. Okay, yeah. I can live with that. Very quick refill. Fill gas up, gas can.
Carl knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gilles Lachance. Any good investigation would have to start there.
Am I not just gonna, like, we're just gonna ignore this bit? Oh, sorry, man. I forgot your body was there. Drive. Can I have a look at my map? Okay, where am I? No, we're turning that off. I can't remember where I need to go. Right. Do I go around or do I go up? Let's go around. So far, so good. It's a bit hit and miss. The narration is getting annoying. I will admit that now. The narration is getting annoying. Rickety bridge. Oh. Oh, don't tell me there's loading screens on every bit. That's alright, it's got a bit more smoother. You know what? Let's have a look up here. I hope I don't have to, like, run out of petrol and have to run back. Really? Yes, 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 yes. Come on. Back up. Turn the engine off! Oh, you idiot. You idiot. The Poopers Clinic. Might have some, mail? Key. Really?
There should be a law forbidding doctors from...
Medical emergency in town. The there is sick. I'll be back soon. If he dies, I won't be returning. I'll have to replace him. Okay. Okay, well, that's a bit weird. Alright. Oh, hello. I love that.
In spite of Dr. Beaupré's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office.
No, it does not.
It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop.
Isabelle Bupi. How about that? Attach wire. Okay, that's a bit weird. Two matches. Nothing in that one. Pots and pans in that one. When locking a door isn't enough. Hmm. Okay. Fill up bottle. Well, we got some water now. That's good.
Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict.
Yes.
Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office.
Fascinated by history. Starring a cool with a constant temperature, they said. Okay, okay, okay. First aid, I love that. Socks.
A chamber pot.
What?
Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
Yes, too right. You don't...
A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time. And even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book?
Yeah. We are in 1970, I believe. So there's a communist Cold War is still in everyone's minds. I never did quite catch a name. The men called her Laurie. She had a neck wound. There was so much blood, the bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The men had found her like this, they said. I doubt it, but in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. I've been told to step back from sending out the death certificate. The whole thing sickens me. Okay. And there's the woman.
The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock.
Potato?
Carl Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes.
Yeah.
Was it Dr. Beaupré, who had hit him head-on at the village border?
It could have been.
Nobody kills a rich patient to start a revolution. It didn't make any sense. He had to dig deeper still to understand. Luckily, that was Carl Faubert's specialty.
Get out of it. I wanted this. Can I look at this?
Doctors used light-reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavities. That was a bit unsettling.
Oh, crap.
But back then, it was pretty much always the case with medicine.
Okay, we got blood. Okay, I got that. So we need to get in there, but we can't. Let's have a look around a bit. Bottle? Okay, what's this? Lantern. That's always good. That's where they keep the wood. Please use the other door. Well, the other door sucks! Okay.
Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
Yeah, I'm not bothered. I don't know what the story is yet. Okay. Let's get out of here. You know what? Let's follow this road round. Oh, wait a minute. It's a dead end. We got more of that funky ice.
Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land as a dog is with hydrants.
Here is the spark plug you ordered for your Olympic Ski-Doo. The model has been very popular as it made it difficult to find a brand new part as quickly as you do. Thank you for choosing the garage product. Gaston Potative. Okay. Can I have it? No? Brake lock. Do I go up there? It looks like a helicopter. It could be just twigs, but... Yeah, it's just a... Nothing there. Let's take a picture of these. Footprints. Going over there. Yeah, down here. Do I have a gun attached? I feel like I should have the gun attached. I feel a bit more... Oh. Okay, the music has really picked up. Whoa!
The man seemed petrified in ice. What Carl saw terrified him, and he didn't know if it was the fear or the cold that was responsible for his hair standing on end all over his body. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to be defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
Oh, that's scary. Too many orange juice bottles. Potatoes. Handlebars.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind. For him to still keep this around.
Okay, okay, okay. We got food. Something isn't right when your bed is in the garage. Yeah, you can say that again. Trust. Nothing interesting in there. Nope. Can I set them pliers? What's this he's been building? Like a spaceship. Homemade flying saucer never ceases to amaze me. Yeah, you can... I can repair this?
The shape of this machine, almost straight out of Star Trek, was out of the ordinary to say.
I'm expecting a nice spark plug around the way.
This thing could fly up into space at any moment. The week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now.
Green milk for little green men. I can't spare that. Oh, that's freaky. Oh, no. What? Where's my torch? Can I have the lantern? Oh, fuck. Oh, holy fuck. Oh, it's his memories, I'm thinking. I'm guessing. Oh, shit, that's breaking. Okay, we're gonna fire. Shit. Something's trying to come in. Everything's breaking. And then it gets very cold. Interesting. Very interesting. I don't know what I need to do. I'm pitch black here. I can't see crap. Oh, there's a little... There he is. Oh, he's put something up there. Okay.
Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it.
Yeah, so we'll it's definitely on the roof. I'm going to... It's just got a bit really interesting now. It's really interesting now. So this is Kona. It's definitely a mystery adventure. I don't know where the survival is yet. Maybe that comes much later on, but... definitely going to carry on with this. Thank you all very much for watching. I have been the Almighty Blob. This has been Kona. Peace and love. And as always, don't do anything I won't do. Bye!